Hello guys, welcome to Online Web Tutor presented by Profotec Solutions team. I am Sanjay. We are learning Backbone JS tutorial from scratch and this is our part 3 of this video session series. So guys, if you are a beginner from this video session, then I strongly recommend you to watch my part 1 and 2 of this video session series, where we have discussed about the introduction part of Backbone JS, working principle of Backbone JS, and how the architecture diagram flows from client-side requests to database, as we have seen in our last two videos. In this video session, we will see about views in Backbone. Let us see the working principle of Backbone JS once more. This is the architectural diagram that guys we had discussed in our part 2 of this video session series, where we had seen that how the client request travels from router section, goes to view sections, means it's the representational part of Backbone JS application, where it fired events and it connects with model and collections, where all business logicals where we define, and finally it attaches with the data source, where it gets data and back to the view section and it will give response to the client. So this is the architectural view guys that we had discussed in part 2 of this video session series. So we are going to discuss about view of Backbone JS in this video session. Let us discuss some of the basic features of view. Just back to our slide. This is the key features guys that I have written to understand the features of view. First, it renders the content. As we know guys that the view section is the representational part of any Backbone JS application, where it takes data from model by the help of events and it renders the content into the view section. It responds the DOM events, means all events are fired from view. Like examples, drag, drop, etc. We will see in later video session about the event sections of view. It is like controllers in MVC architecture of any application, where all controls are going from a page, and this is the view section of Backbone. It have a DOM element. Basically, to interact with the DOM element, DOM object, it has a jQuery object. By the help of selector, it connects with the DOM elements of a page. Means it has the property of L property, EL, where $EL and EL, $EL basically a jQuery object which refers to the DOM element, and the property EL refers to the DOM element of the page. So let's get started with a program. Just open your folder in which you have stored your files like Backbone jQuery underscore JS. We had discussed guys in our first part that what are the basic requirements that we need to run a Backbone JS application. So just I am open message.html to run our first view program, and this is the file guys that we have coded so far. And you need to understand guys, to run a Backbone JS application, you need to link these files according to their order. First jQuery file, second underscore JS, and third one is the Backbone JS file. These three files helps you to run your Backbone JS application. And this is basic syntax of jQuery. Now we are going to make our first view. So basically to create our first view, let's make an object like first view. And basically, to make a view, we need to extend backbone.view property. Backbone.view, by using backbone.view, we can extend its view feature and we can define our own definitions under this section. Every Backbone view has a property called render, where it runs our representational part. Let's make a console message to test it. Hello online web tutor. This is the representational part where it goes initiated by using render property. So to make first view run, just copy the name of this and just we have to initiate to run this. First view equal to new. Just go to our browser. This is the browser, guys. Message.html, as you can see. Just Control F5 to refresh. No console message, as we can see in console.log. Why it is happening? Because we didn't call the render method for now. Just we need to call this function. So fview.render. Control S to save, Control F5 to refresh. As we can see, guys, hello online web tutor is the console message that we have given for now to our program. So basically, render method is used in views to represent our messages or our data objects to our application. By default, guys, we don't need render method to call it. If we have used in slice method, initialized, under this method we need to call the render method. So when we make our object of first view, then it automatically calls in slice method. By the help of this method, we automatically called the render method where it has given the console message. So by using this as a property, we don't need to call this. So Control S to save, just Control F5 to refresh. As we can say, guys, our custom message here appears now. So this is the very basic syntax that we need to follow to run our first view application. So the second features, if you are talking about, have a DOM element, means by default Backbone.js has a jQuery object which basically refers to the DOM element. Let us check. To check that, just we need to write console.log this dot $el. Control S to save, Control F5 to refresh. As we can see, guys, div here, it's a jQuery selector which basically refers to a DOM element. Basically, Backbone.js automatically creates an empty div as a DOM element, but it doesn't take any memory for now. Just if you want to give a memory location to our HTML page, we need to define a DOM element, and we need to pass that DOM element to this jQuery selector. Okay, guys, so $el is nothing, it's a jQuery object. jQuery object which basically refers to the DOM element. We need to make sure that by default this dot $el makes empty div element, but to allocate the memory for that div element, we need to pass a jQuery selector to this object. To pass a DOM element to this, we need to pass EL property for that. Suppose I have given ID content, so we have to make a div ID content. So this is the DOM element, guys, that we have made with the ID content, and we have passed this ID to this selector, and it's a DOM element selector, jQuery selector. By the help of this jQuery selector, the jQuery object that is $el allocates its memory into the HTML page. So how can we use it? This .el.html, and here is the custom message. Just Control S to save, Control F5 to refresh. As we can see, guys, this is the custom message that we have written here. This .el is the jQuery object which refers to the DOM element, and this DOM element we have passed, as you can see, ID content. This is the DOM element, okay guys, and this DOM element guys actually referred from jQuery selector. So basically if you want to allocate a memory to this dot dollar real, we need to pass a DOM element. Let me show you what is the difference between this dot real, this dot dollar real. As you can see guys, the statement that is written is console.log this dot el. This dot el basically a DOM element, as you can see div id, but this dot dollar el is the jQuery object which refers to the DOM element. Here div has content is the id and div is the DOM element. So basically this dot dollar el refers to the DOM element. Okay guys, so I think I have made much more clear concept about this dot el and this dot dollar el. And as we have seen that what is the basic purpose of initialize method. When we use initialize method, then don't need to include object dot render method, because it automatically calls initialize method while making our view, initiating our view. So if you go to our browser and inspect this element, then as we can see div id content, and as we know guys that this dot dollar el automatically creates a div element. Okay, so if you want to change the div element to something else, then we need to pass here as tag name. So let's remove the DOM element that we have given for now and just comment it for now. Ctrl F5 to refresh. So by default this dot dollar el makes the div DOM element by default. It automatically creates a div, as you can see here. So if you want to change the tag name, if you want to change the default tag name it has actually created for now, so we have to pass tag name. Control S to save, Control F to refresh. As we can see span, here is our custom message and this is the dollar el. So by default Backbone has a default DOM element of div and jQuery object which refers to the DOM element of span. So here we have changed the DOM element name from div to span, because if you want to pass the tag name, then it automatically picks the value, otherwise it gives by default the div as a DOM selector. And if you want to suppose pass as class name, we can give minimal property to this view like owt. Also we can pass id like 1234. Control S to save and refresh. As we can see, this is the span tag actually created by the DOM element span, where id is 1234 that we have given, as you can see, and the class name is owt. So this is guys that how we can create views in Backbone. One more thing guys, you have to keep in your mind that about el and dollar el, this dot el is the DOM element referrer, where this one is the jQuery object basically refers to this DOM element. If we suppose pass here el content, here we have specified the DOM element that all the contents this view should render into this id, means we have given this DOM element as the target path for the content to be set. So let's refresh that. Let's inspect that. This is the area guys that we have given to this area, where it actually renders the content into this div element here, as we can see as we have specified. So this is the very basic use of guys of Backbone view into the Backbone.js application. Let's summarize this video session. If you want to create Backbone view, then you must extend Backbone.view property. After extending this Backbone.view, you need to pass initialize method. If you don't want to create this section. If you have created this section, they don't need to include in slice method. Okay guys, because you have automatically called the render method here, you have defined as a property. But when in slice method is there, then we don't need to include this section. And also you have made some DOM elements into the HTML page, then by passing a DOM element as a EL property for this view, as a EL property for this view, then this $EL refers to this DOM element, and all of the contents here we have written is by default goes here, because this is a DOM element as we have passed by the name of EL. So in this video session we have seen the use of this .el, this $EL. We have seen the attributes like tag name, class name, id in slice and render method. So in next video session we will see about the event section of backbone.view. So guys, if you have any query about this video session about backbone view extending, what are the parameters that we have passed, and also you have any type of suggestion if you want to give us to means make video much more beneficial for you, then it's my pleasure to grab your suggestions for backbone just tutorial. So let's make some clear point to you. This $EL is a jQuery object, refers to the DOM object EL, and this .el basically a jQuery selector. Here is the attributes guys that we have passed so far to our backbone view, like tag name, class name, id, render and slice. So these are the properties of backbone.view, and this is how the syntax that we extend the backbone view in backbone JS. So here are the features that we have seen. It have a DOM element, as we have seen this $EL is the by default jQuery selector which refers to DOM element of div, and if you have passed any tag name then it picks this path beyond the use of default, and it responds to DOM events. In the next video session we will see about the DOM events in great detail. So if you have any query guys, then put your comments in comment box. I will give my reply as soon as possible. And one more thing guys, if you go to the online web tutor YouTube page, then you will find several videos we have made about the WordPress customizations in plugin, theme, wizard, theme options. So if you want to learn about WordPress, or if you are a lover of WordPress technology, then you can find several resources we have provided for free to online web tutor YouTube channel. So guys, for this video session, thank you for watching. Have a great day.